Hey, it's Kimberly again. For those of you that don't know me or don't know exactly what I'm talking about or what I'm going through, I want to let you know. So, ever since 2000, I mean, fuck, I can't even talk. Ever since September of 2011, I have been addicted to Oxy30s. Before I got addicted to these, I had my daughter Talia, and I gained some weight, and I ended up being like 165 pounds, and for me being 5'2", it's not good. It didn't look good. But anyways, so I was insecure about my weight. I started doing pills. And 4 months after I started, I dropped the most weight I've ever dropped. Before I did pills, I weighed 165 pounds, and then 4 months later, I'm weighing 120 pounds. Like, it was disgusting. I got just way too skinny. My face was being like sunk in, like my cheeks, and it wasn't good. Here's for people that don't understand. Because I can't stand it when somebody tries to tell you something about an addiction that they have no idea about. This is something that bothers me, is like when people be like, "Oh, well, why don't you just quit? You know, it's easy, you know." No, motherfucker, like, get real. If you haven't done it, you have no idea what it feels like. You don't know the experience, the pains. You don't know what the hell we go through, people like me, you know, that are addicted to this shit. What I like to call it is, I call it the devil, because it really is, man, is the fucking devil. You wake up every morning and that's what you're doing. You're chasing the devil. You're gonna find any way you can. Technically, not any, but if you're going through withdrawals, the withdrawals are hell. It starts off with, you know, it's like a really, really bad flu. You know, I mean, you could either be constipated or you can have the shits. You puke. You get really bad abdominal pains that are just like, ugh, excruciating. You get restless leg syndrome. You get really bad cramps in your legs. It's hard to sleep. Body sweats, like you could be really hot, and then you could be really cold, but your body's still sweating. God, yawning is another symptom. Me right now, you know, it's really disgusting to talk about, but it's the truth. Every morning when I wake up, I cough, and my cough is, you know, it's from them, and I cough up black shit. And it's really disgusting. But anyways, with my experience and going through all this, I've noticed a big change. I'm not myself. And it hurts when your family tells you that they want Kimberly. They want her back. You know, they, and I'm confused, because I'm thinking like, I'm right here, I'm right here. But deep down it's like, no. You're not Kimberly. You're not you. You're a whole different person. You know, you're just not you no more. And it's like every day when I wake up, I always have a hard time looking at myself in the mirror. As you can see with me doing this video, I have a hard time looking at myself right now. But when I'm on these pills and I look at myself in the mirror, I don't see me. I see some girl who is lost, confused, sad, mad, just everything is negative. There's like no positive whatsoever, and it hurts. It hurts a lot. People always look at me, and when they find out that I'm addicted to Oxys, it's hard for them to believe. And as I've been doing these, I've been through some shit. I've been judged. I've been discriminated against. I've been belittled. I've been beat up by my exes. There's a lot of hurt, you know? And that's one of the reasons why I want to change so bad. Is because I'm tired of waking up and being sick. I'm tired of when I'm sick that I just think that why won't God take me out of this pain? Why do I have to go through these pains? They hurt, and then, you know, nobody's perfect. Everybody has some kind of an addiction, something wrong with them, whatever it is, but we continue to get judged for our mistakes, for, you know, like people, one thing I always hear is, you know, people, they, oh, why don't you just quit? You know? Like, it's so fucking easy. Are you serious? I've tried to quit a few times, and but, you know, that's not gonna stop me from keep trying. I guess one of the reasons why I was scared to quit was because I was scared to face myself. I was scared to